Hi everyone, today we are going to learn sum of subsets problem. So first of all I'll explain the problem and I'll then show how this problem can be solved using backtracking. So first of all let us see what is sum of subsets problem. See what is sum of subsets problem. In sum of subset problem, you are given with weights, okay, as a set. Okay, we are given with a set of weights. We have to take a subset from that, or we have to select the subsets from that set in such a way that sum of the elements of the subset is exactly equal to a given integer value m. Okay, so here the problem is very simple. A set will be given with some weights. Okay, so from that you have to select all possible subsets whose sum of elements will be equal to a value m. Okay, so selection of weights for the subset can be done in various ways, but we have to find the selection of which weight will lead us to the values given value m. Okay, so usually how this problem we are going to solve is we'll draw a solution tree for this, and I will explain how backtracking can be applied to get the solution. Okay, so usually here we will draw a solution tree where I'm going to check all possibilities by either including the weight or not including the weight. Okay, the solution tree will I'll usually draw like this. So I'll start with the root node, and then first I'll try to include the first weight, that is weight 1. If I include, what will be my sum? I'll check. Okay, if it is not exceeding, okay, or if it is exceeding the given value m, then I'll check with by not including the weight 1. Okay, next, if it is not exceeding the m, then I will try to include weight 2. I will try to include weight 2. If it is exceeding value m, I'll try with not including weight 2. Okay, so here also once again I'll check by including weight 2, okay, then by not including weight 2. Then if it is not exceeding m, once again I'll check with by including weight 3. What will be the sum? I'll check. And if it is exceeding m, then I'll check by not including weight 3. Like this, at some point I'm going to get a solution. Okay, at some point I'll get a solution, that is my total sum will be exactly equal to the given value m. Okay, so I have to find out all those possibilities. See, when the solution tree completes, at the end it comes, so you will be having the n number of solutions for this particular problem. So this is your problem. So now let us consider a simple problem and try to understand this problem. Okay, so here you can observe this is a small set given here. Here n value is 4 and the set given is 7, 11, 13 and 24 are the elements, and you have to find the subsets in such a way that sum of that elements will be equal to the value m, given value m, that is 31. So m I have taken here as 31. Okay, so what may be the solution? See, which elements if I add I'll get 31. See, one of the solutions will be if I add first three elements, say 7, 11 and 13, what I'm going to get? I'm going to get 31. Okay, if you add 7, 11 and 13, I'm going to get 31. So it is one of the solution. What may be the other solution? The other solution may be say set 2 will be if I add 7 and 24, first and last element, what is the solution I'm going to get? 7 plus 24, 31. So like this, there may be n number of solutions. We have to find all such subsets whose sum of elements will be equal to the value m, that is 31. So this is my problem. Okay, so how I'm going to solve this is I'll first draw a solution tree for this. So how I'm going to draw a solution tree? See, first I'm going to start with a root node. So what is this root node contains? Usually our node contains will have two elements. One is what is the weight so far included in your solution tree or to the sum, that is your first element. Till now I have not included any element into the subset, that's why my sum is 0. And what is the total remaining weight available in your subset? So what is the total weight available? 7 plus 11 plus 13 plus 24, it will be 55. Okay, so this is my first node. And sum so far the weights included is 0, so that's why I have taken sum as 0. Now what I'll do is I'll try to include the first weight. If I tried included first weight, then what happens? Okay, that I'll check. If I include first weight, then what happens? what is my first weight? That is 7. I'll try by including it. Okay, another side of the tree will be, if I not include 7, then what will be my sum? Okay, if I include 7, what will be my sum? 0 plus 7, it is 7, and the remaining weight is 7 already I have included, so I have to subtract 7 from this 55, so the remaining weight will be here 48. 55 minus 7, so that is 48. Okay, so here you can observe sum I have got is 7 till now. It's not at exceeded 31, so I'll continue. Okay, I'll try to include the next weight. So which is the next weight I'll have? Okay, so the next weight I'll have is say 11. So the next weight is 11, so I'll try to include that. If I include 11, it is 11 plus 7, so it is 18. And what is the remaining weight? 48 minus 11. So 48 minus 11 is 37. Right? Okay. So still 18, it has come up to 18. So it has not yet exceeded 31. So I will try to include one more weight. Which is the one more weight? Which is the next weight I have? I have next, 13. 13 is my next weight. Okay, I'll try to include that. If I include that, 18 plus 13, what is my weight now? So 18 plus 13, it is 31. Okay, and what is the remaining weight? Remaining weight is 24. Further, I will not continue because I have got my first solution, that is 31. Exactly this, by including these three weights, I am getting the final solution as 31. Okay. If I continue now, what happens is the weight exceeds 31. So it's of it's fruitless. So I will stop here. So I have got my first solution. Which is my first solution? So my first solution that I got is, okay. So my first solution that I got is solution 1 is, see, I'll take an array to represent that. Okay, so first weight included, you can observe 7 included, second weight also included, third weight also included, but fourth weight I have not included. Fourth weight is 24, I have not included. So your first subset solution is first weight included, second weight included, third weight included. This is your first solution, right? Okay, so there may be another any other subsets also may be available in this particular solution. Okay, so I have to find out all subsets, all possible subsets. So I'll try to find the remaining subset. What I'll do now, I will stop here and I'll go back. I'll do backtracking and I'll go back now. So here I'll try by not including the 13. Okay, I'll try by not including 13. If I not include 13, if I not include the weight 13, what will happen? The sum will remain same because I'm not including 13. What happens to the remaining weight? 37 minus 13 that I have to do, that is 24. So I got 24 here. Still it has not exceeded 31. So I'll continue here. So I'll include the next weight, which is my next weight. What is the last weight? So fourth weight, that is 24. I'll try to include it. If I include it, 24, if I include 24 plus 18, what it will be? It will be 42. Total sum. Okay, but remaining weight will be 24 minus 24, 0. You can observe here the weight has, the sum has is exceeding 31. Okay, so I have to stop here. I have to stop here, or I have to kill this particular node. Okay, I have to stop and kill this node with some bounding function. So what is this bounding function is? Bounding function will is a condition, okay, which will check whether the weight so far included, whether it is exceeding m. So what is the bounding function to kill this particular node? So the bounding function is, will go like this. So the weight so far included, weight so far included, okay, WSF is weight so far included, sum of all the weights so far included, where I starts from 1 to k, plus the next weight. What will be the next weight? Say k plus 1. It should be always less than or equal to m. So this is your first bounding condition. So what is our first bounding condition? Weight so far included plus next weight should be less than or equal to m. If it is not less than or equal to m, I have to discard that, or I have to kill that particular node. Next, what I should do, I obviously can't continue. So I will go back. I'll go back, backtracking, and I will try by not including the weight 24. I'll try by not including the weight 24. If I not include 24, what will be your solution? It will be 18 18 as it is, because I'm not including any weight. 24 minus 24, it will be 0. Okay. This is also, you can observe, this is also meaningless. Why? Because you don't have enough weight, okay, to manage the weight 31. Isn't it? So you don't have the remaining weight at all. So obviously you cannot add any weight, or you will not finally reach 31 at all. There is no possibility. So there is no meaning in continuing here. So I have to stop here. So what is the second bounding condition here? Second bounding condition is weight so far included, that is I equal to 1 to k, sum of weight so far included plus remaining weight. That is remaining weight in the sense, sum of remaining weight in the sense from k plus 1 to up to n, it should be greater than m. Okay. Sum of weight so far included plus remaining weight sum should be greater than m. Then only I can continue. So because of the second bounding condition, I am not including this. Okay. So I'll go back. Okay. So I have finished both the sides here. So I'll go back here. So I'll continue from here. Right side of this particular node. What is the right side of this node? So 11 I have included here. I'll try by not including 11. If I not include 11, what happens? If I not include 11, this sum will remain same. 48 minus 11, it will be 37. Okay. So second weight is done. So I'll try to include third weight. If I include third weight, okay. What happens if I include third weight? Okay, so third weight is what? 13. If I include 13, 13 plus 7, it is 20, and 37 minus 13, it is 24. Okay, next I'll take the left part of this. I'll try to include 24. If I include 24, what happens? So 20 plus 24, it is 44, isn't it? 44 and 24 minus 24, 0. But here you can observe 31, it is exceeding. So 44 is exceeding 31, and the remaining weight also has become 0. So that we have to kill this, or there is no meaning in continuing this. Okay. So I'll try this one by not including 24. By not including 24, that is 24 not including. If I'm not including 24, then what is this? Then it is 20 only, it will remain. 24 minus 24, 0. Even though the weight is 20 here, there is no remaining weight at all. So there is no meaning in continuing here. So I have to discard this. Okay. So I will go back here. I have to take the right subtree of this node. If I take the right subtree of this node by not including 13, what happens? Okay. So if I'm not including 37, it is 7 only. And remaining weight is 37 minus 13, it is 24. Right. Okay, now I'll try to include the fourth weight. Third weight already I have checked, so I'll try to include the fourth weight. If I include the fourth weight, which is the fourth weight? 24. I'll try to include it. If I include it, 24 plus 7, it is 31. And what is the remaining weight? 0. So you can observe I have got the exact sum 31 in this case. So what is the path? If you go back, you can observe 7 included, 11 not included, 13 not included, 24 included. So first weight included and last weight included. So I am getting the second solution here. What is my second solution? If I represent it in array, so first weight included, second weight not included, third weight not included, fourth weight included. So first weight included, second not included, third not included, fourth included. So this second solution is 7 and 24 included. So I got the second solution. I got my second solution here. Okay. Now, like this, if you continue the tree, when the entire tree, when you finish, I'm going to get all possible solution. See, till now I have got two. This is one, first, second and third included, and the second set is first and fourth included. Okay. So like this, if I continue recursively, the entire solution tree, when it completes, then see, you have four levels here. That means you will get 2 to a power, that is 16 nodes. So when I'm going to get that, complete that particular tree, I'm going to get all the subset solution. Okay. Mainly two conditions you have to check here in order to kill a node. Okay. Or bounding conditions. Which are the bounding conditions? Weight so far included. Okay. Plus the next weight should be always less than or equal to m, and weight so far included plus remaining weight should be greater than m. So if you are checking this within the for loop, And recursively, if you call subset function, then I'm going to get all possible solutions for the subsets. Okay, this is your sum of subsets problem.